Hey guys, it's Georgia and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to be doing exactly what the title of this video is because I don't fulfill false hopes. I think that was the right thing to say. I don't know if that makes sense. But anyway, yeah, today is our homecoming game here at the University of Cincinnati where I attend college. And we are playing against East Carolina University. My cousin went there. Boo Pirates. So yeah, I haven't done any like get ready with me makeup videos. Like I had my prom vlog, but I didn't have anything like chatty and like telling you what products I use. It was just kind of like a fun montage. So I figured today, let's just go right into it. Okay. So I'm going to be starting out with my Master Prime Maybelline by Face Studio. I don't really know if it works. It's supposed to be like a green concealer for like red spots and If you couldn't already tell, my hair is wet and I'm gonna dry it later. Okay? So I don't need your negativity. Thank you. I forgot to wet my beauty blender. I'll be back in for like, it's gonna be 1 second for you, but it's gonna be roughly 30 seconds for me, okay? All right, cool. Okay. I'm back and better than ever with the beauty blender, and I also decided to put my hair up because on the lowest of keys, I started looking like an egg. All right, next I'm going to take my all-time favorite foundation. It is the Maybelline Fit Me New York Matte Poreless. It's in the color ivory because if you couldn't tell, I have very pale skin. It just happens that way. And I know, like, you're supposed to do your eye makeup before your face makeup, but I've been living this routine for such a long time that I just can't do it. I accidentally got too much. I always try and like scoop the remnants back in because I'm a saver. And for all you hooligans wondering where I got this beauty blender, I got it at Sephora. You see, originally I had a pink one, but it got super gross and super dirty, so that's why I got the nude one. So you can't see my gross foundation on it. I just forgot that I have to put in my contacts, so I have to go wash my hands now. I'll be back in another 1 second for you, but like 2 minutes for me. Great. I decided not to. I decided not to record putting in my contacts because I thought that that would be boring. And I already did it in my prom blog. And some people get like freaked out by eye stuff. So I have vision now though. All right, next I'm going in with the Born This Way Too Faced Concealer. It's like a gift sent down from heaven. It's honestly my favorite concealer, and obviously I'm not sponsored for any of this stuff because I only have 1,200 subscribers, which isn't something I should say only to, but that makes me so happy, I'm so excited. But like, obviously you don't get sponsored this early into your career. So, yeah, none of this is sponsored. This is just honestly my favorite mascara. My favorite concealer. I have it in the shade Very Fair, because I'm fair, and when you get concealer, you want to go lighter, so the only other option for me is Very Fair. Okay. What I do is like the casual, you know, the casual to try. I'll just show you. When I'm going out, I like to pull the concealer all the way back to my cheekbones to kind of give it like a highlighter look. Even I do use highlighter later, but it's just kind of even more. Alright, so this is what I do on the concealer front. Obviously, I'm just like the triangles, nose, corners of my nose. I have a little red spot here from in May. I got a pimple there, and it's just kind of been a red spot ever since. I'll have to figure that out. And I have a little blemish up there, so I'm just gonna conceal it. And I'm kind of having like dark under... I'm sorry, I'm trying to make plans for the tailgate. 20 seconds, that's all I need for me. What? We've already been down this road. Okay, so situation figured out. I'm actually tailgating with some girls in my sorority. I'm tailgating with like my fam, which is my big, my twiddle, my potentially my great grand big and great great grand big. And maybe my grand big, I don't know. We'll see. Okay, next I'm going to do contouring. And this is not, this is like a Fit Me stick, which is like a concealer stick, but I just got it in obviously not my skin tone, but a skin tone for contouring. I got it in the 330 number. It's the Fit Me Shine Free stick, I guess. Foundation stick. It's a foundation stick. I saw someone do this on YouTube. I forget who the user was, but she had a really good tutorial. I'll let you know if I find it. Here we go. I always go from my cheekbones down to like the pupil in my eye, and I suck in so I can see the natural shape of my cheekbones. And then I just like to go down my jawline. And of course, across the forehead. And finally, I just do my little like circles by my top of my forehead, I guess you could say. So now that I look like an alien, let's get to blending. It always looks so bad on camera because this like lighting is very strange, one could say. Oh, I'm just gonna take a powder real quick and go over it. I think it looks fine. I used the Bare Minerals Original Foundation Broad Spectrum SPF 15 in Medium Beige. And I just used this brush that my mom gave me that's Bare Essentials. Now back to blending. Wait, what the heck? I dropped my beauty blender and now it's disappeared. This is not good. Oh, found it. Back and better than ever. So now that I'm done with the foundation contouring, I go in with my powder contouring palette. It is the My Sculpted Face from It Cosmetics. I got it from, that one place that everyone goes to for makeup. Not Sephora. Ulta. I got it from Ulta. I'm basically just doing everything that I did with the Fit Me stick, but with this powder. I personally like to go down the route of like mixing these three and then like just like going for it. And sometimes I'll use that one if it's like a fancy night. All right, next I'm going in with my Bare Minerals blush. It's called Fruit Cocktail. I've had this since I was a freshman in high school. Like, that's how long it's lasted me, and I wear this every single time I put on makeup. It's a very, very pigmented pink, but like, if you like only use a little bit, that's like perfectly how much you need. And I'm using the Soft Focus Face Bare Minerals brush with it. And like, I do like this blush, but I kind of like, you know, want something new since I've been using this for like a solid 4 years. I don't know, if you have any suggestions about your favorite kind of blushes, comment them down below. That'd be really appreciated. When I put on blush, I do like what I do for contouring. I just suck in And then I go down my cheekbones, then I smile. A solid closed mouth smile. And just go around the apples of my cheeks, if that's the correct thing to say. Perfecto. And then I like to go in with a beauty blender just to like bring it all together, make sure it doesn't look like a clown. And finally, for my face products, I'll be taking the Too Faced Candlelit Glow Highlighter. It's called Rosy Glow. It's absolutely beautiful. Like, just look at that. Oh, so pretty. So I take, it's like, this is like a pack that my sister bought from Walgreens of like makeup brushes that like aren't, like they're not bad, but they're obviously not professional makeup brushes. I just took them from her because she doesn't wear makeup. Hopefully you're not watching this, Hope. So what I do with this is I just go around in a circle and then I'm just gonna go along like naturally where like the highlight of my face is. You can kind of see like a natural thing going there, so I'm gonna try and mimic that with the highlighter. And now that I'm done with like the highlight up here, it looks really, really crazy on camera, but I swear none of this is in real life. Oh god, it's making me nervous. Let me tell you that. Next, I like to take a little bit and then just go like down the bridge of my nose, like just give it a cute little a little bit on my forehead above my Cupid's bow, and that's all. Next we're going in with winged eyeliner. This is not one of my strong suits, I'll tell you that. All right, wish me luck. I'm pretty happy with it. Well, let us continue. You know, I think it looks good. So I'm leaving it. I'm not doing eyeshadow today, quite frankly, because I don't feel like it. Now to complete the collection, we'll be going in... Oh my god, I forgot to tell you what eyeliner I used. I used the Voluminous Superstar L'Oreal Paris Liquid Eyeliner. Come on, nah. Come on, nah. There we go. Buy it if you want to use it. I think it's good. I don't really do... You know, I've never really been a winged eyeliner kind of girl because I was always really bad at it. But then when I came to college, I was like, I don't deserve to live this life anymore. I should get to live with the luxury of winged eyeliner. So I do it now. Now we're going to go in with the brows. I like to use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz in the color... I'm gonna screw this up so badly. Taupe. Oh god, there's something in my contact. And I can't use contact solution anymore because I just did my eyeliner. You know what? I'm gonna try anyway. Let's see how we can do this. Aha! Oh god, it just hurts. I think I nailed it. Got that sucker. That's one sucky thing about makeup and contacts, is that something can get in your contacts and ruin your life. Now I have to fix my eyeliner. How embarrassing. Beautiful. Okay, now we're going with the brows. Let's do this. You see, I used to like get my eyebrows done like pretty often, like monthly or bi-monthly. But with modeling, you can't get your eyebrows done. So for a while when that was like really going for me, I didn't do my eyebrows. And then whenever I did get my eyebrows waxed, I'd break out into hives all over here because I have very sensitive skin. So I guess like the wax and like the ripping of the skin just didn't agree with my lifestyle. So I got my eyebrows threaded once, and honestly, so much pain. It was really painful, but I didn't like break out, and it was at a spa, so she like made it nice and cool after. But like, so yeah, I've just, since my eyebrows like are pretty fair, because my hair is so blonde, you can't really see them that much at the ends. So like I can get away with filling them in, but I don't know. I might get them done over break. I haven't decided yet. I probably will, just as like a restart. We'll see. But the last time I got them threaded, she threaded them very thinly, and I'm not a thin eyebrow gal. So if anyone knows of any great eyebrow threaders in Cincinnati, Ohio, let me know. Who's excited for Christmas? I know I am. I've been listening to nothing but my Christmas Spotify playlist for the past couple weeks, and I will continue that until December and past that. Beautiful. Next, on to hair. Be right back. We're just gonna start off with blow drying. Perfect. Now we'll go in with the straightener. How embarrassing is it that I forgot to do mascara? We're gonna go in with my MAC mascara and then my Maybelline. Let's go. Forgot to curl them. I'm falling apart. And now to clean up the screw-ups. Oh god. We're gonna go back in with the eyeliner. It's the wrong eyeliner. There we go. My lips are feeling rather chapped. Now for straightening. And now for a few last minute touches. Let's go, cats. Okay, here's the final look, everyone. I'll do a quick. I'm wearing my North Face white vest to go with it, because you see it's like red and black, but obviously there's some white in there. I have a red homecoming shirt that low-key says win or lose, we still booze. I'm not here to condone underage drinking. I just wanted to be included in the t-shirt sale. I have my gold necklace that says 513 because that is the area code Cincinnati. I have my cute little UC things. And to top it all off, bean boots. Okay, that's all for this week, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Comment down below if you have any suggestions for what kind of videos you want to see. Once again, like your favorite makeup products, I'll make sure to list all the makeup products that I used in this video down below. Don't forget to follow me on social media. Follow me on Instagram at Georgia Bridgers, on Twitter at Georgia Bridgers with a capital G and a capital B, and follow me on Snapchat at Georgia.Bridge. Once again, thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. If you're new here, welcome. I make a video every week. You're probably super used to every YouTuber saying that, and I don't have a response to that, so subscribe if you're cool. Peace, bye, love you. Ooh, 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 okay, okay. Go Cats.